everyone, welcome to my channel. We have been doing a lot of DIY videos on this channel lately, and today is also one of the DIY videos. In this video, we are going to make two organizers and one decor item. I really own a lot of stationery. I have been hoarding stationery for quite some time now, and since some time I am actually into some collaborations due to which I am getting a lot of stationery at my home, but I don't really have the space to keep them, or basically I don't find them, you know, handy. Jaise ki they are all in boxes. I just wanted them in front of me so that I can use whatever I want to whenever I want to. So I really wanted to organize my stuff, but all of these beautiful acrylic type of organizers on Amazon, they were super costly and I didn't want to go overboard with spending. So I just DIY'd everything and I made few organizers that look cute and aesthetic for your room overall. So today we are going to make them, and without wasting any time, let's just get directly into the video. I don't know why my face is so puffy today, but okay. So for the first DIY, we are making organizer number one. Now I don't really have a name for it, but yeah, I used it to organize all my paint tubes. You can use any specific thing, like if you are a makeup person, you can use it for lipsticks and various stuff. Like it can be used for anything. So starting out, I used a cereal box, these foil paper rolls, and you will need any paint if you want to, and just some scissors. So I'm just cutting off the top portion of the cereal box. Remember, I'm not cutting the sides, just the top rectangle, because we need the sides. So what I've done is, after cutting this, I have just joined this fourth side also, which was open, using a tape so that it is sealed properly and it forms the shape of a box. Basically, so now I am using just some glue. I have used this very cheap glue. It is from Camlin. I am not using Fevicol because I was out of it. I didn't have much, so I used this glue. And then I just cut out some scrap papers, and I'm doing this paper mache technique. Now in this technique, what do we do is, we add like one part of glue and two parts of water. Okay, so in that little bowl next to the box, I have added one part of glue and two parts of water. And then we just, using a brush or anything, you just apply glue on the box and just put some paper on it. Okay, this makes the surface very hard and it is sturdy enough. Then I have just taken some white paint and just painted over the entire box properly. Now I'm taking my foil paper roll and I have measured 4 cm on the roll. So I am taking 4 cm. You can take according to the height of your box. My cereal box was 4 cm in height, so I used 4 cm. And then I just, using a cutter, I have just cut these rolls. Now my foil paper roll was really thick, and it was very difficult to cut, so I was really struggling with it. So make sure if you're doing this DIY, you have someone next to you who can help you with the cutting. And if you're not old enough, please don't do this yourself. Please take help from some elder person. And then I've just taken the box. It was dried enough and it was hard, so I just took some turquoise paint and painted inside the box. Now you know that I am really liking turquoise these days, so I just maintained that color scheme of my room a little bit. Actually, I don't know that scheme is there or not, but yeah, I really like turquoise color. So I just painted inside the box completely. Then I have just taken the rolls and placed them inside the box. Now you can stick them using Fevicol, Fevibond, any particular glue that you want to. So I have pasted 6 rolls because I was short of rolls, and I just thought that okay, I will just divide this leftover space in this way, and it turned out cute. So then I have just used my turquoise paint and painted it completely, and this looks like this with all the paint tubes organized properly.
Okay, so the second organizer that we are making today is, I made it mainly to organize my pens and sketch pens and all of this stuff. So I'm basically making a pen stand sort of a thing. You can use it to organize anything. Like it can be used in your kitchen, for your kitchen utensils, for your makeup liners, lip liners and stuff, many things.
Now for this we need some cardboard, scissors, scale, a pencil, and any of these like plastic or paper cups, whatever you have at home, or you can take that, some tape and some paints to cover them up later. Now what I'm doing is I have just taken this cardboard of 41 centimeter in length. Now I know 41 is a little weird, but I don't know why I did take that length, but yeah, it's 41 centimeter in length and it has these 8 centimeter flaps on the side. Both of the parts have flaps on the side, and the one of them has 8 centimeter flap on the lower end as well, as you can see. Now what I've done is, using them, I have just made a rectangular box. You can totally use any particular dimension that you wish to, it's totally up to you. I have just used some tape and connected this whole thing like this. Now don't worry, you must be thinking the tape is not that much sturdy, but we will make it sturdy very very soon, and it will turn out very good. So now what I've done, when this is completely stuck properly, I have just taken some glasses, I am taking plastic glasses here, and I have just put them one by one next to each other in the rectangular box. Now I was left with little space on the side, but that's fine, we'll cover it up, no problem. I have actually changed my mind and I used white cement in place of paint, because paints would be wasted a lot. It was a big box. I just took some water and, using a cardboard, chota sa cardboard ka strip, I have just mixed this white cement properly. Now with white cement, I don't know why, but it does harden quickly, so make sure you mix that when you're ready with your DIY. Then I just shifted to the floor because I didn't want to make any dirt on my table, and I have just put this white cement using that same cardboard strip on the box. Now I have covered it with very thick layer of white cement, that way it became very very sturdy and it looked very very nice with all of that texture. So I have just done that on the front and on both the sides. Now I did a little cheating here in this DIY. I didn't cover the back side of it because first of all I was just covering it when it was lying down, so it was a little difficult to just pick it up and do at the back side also. But that's fine, that is going to be up against the wall, so that's not a problem. Then again I used the same color technique. I just took some turquoise paint and I painted inside. Now one more tip here, you don't have to just color up till the end of it. If you're just lacking some paint or if you have less paint, you can totally just paint on the top ends like I have done. That is totally fine because the other end is not going to be visible also. So I have just done that here, and yeah, we are done with the entire DIY and it looks so so pretty and so aesthetic.
So now for the third DIY, this is not an organizer, it is a decor piece. So remember in my last video, I made a rope rug. Now if you have not seen that, the video is up here, you can go and check it out. But this is what I made exactly, a rope rug. So I kept my plants on it, but I want to make it a little more cute.
So I have just used some stones. Now I got these stones one time from my trip and I was just having them lying around, so I used these. And I have used these little stones and pearl sort of thing that was just not very useful to me, so I used that. And some paints, this, remember in my last video I just cut out this excess rope, so I am gonna use that in this DIY. And I used this little bucket container sort of a thing. I had this from sometime, I got it from store 99 at just 99 rupees, very very long ago, so I thought I could just use it. Then I just took some paint, different shades of green or basically very dark turquoise. I took those shades and I have just painted all over my stones using different colors. Now I just took, I guess, 5 stones and I am just covering all of them with different colors. When they were dry enough, I just took a marker. This is a permanent board marker and I have made some eyes and little flowers on those stones. Now just to give you an idea, you must have guessed by now, these are little cactus that I'm making in the form of मतलब बेसिकली फ्रॉम स्टोन्स. सो आई जस्ट मेड सम आईज, आई लैशेज, सम फ्लावर्स टू जस्ट मेक देम क्यूट अ लिटल. एंड यू कैन टोटली गो अहेड एंड डू एज आई एम डूइंग, बट यू कैन टोटली कस्टमाइज इट अकॉर्डिंग टू योर सेल्फ एंड यू नो जस्ट चेंज द होल डिज़ाइन एंड एवरीथिंग. दैट्स टोटली अप टू यू. When I was done with the designs, I just took some white acrylic paint and a thin brush, and I made these lines. Basically, I'm just making some designs on the whole cactus. I'm sort of making the spikes that are there on the cactus. Now, I have used different designs for all the five cactus that I was making. You can use one similar design only, and you can just mix and match as the way you want to. But I guess I just try to cover different designs so that you all can get an idea that how can you make these cactuses. And then I just painted over these flowers with different colors to add a different pop of color to the whole cactus. Now I'm just using my container. I have placed these stones and all pearls and different type of stuff. And on the top I have placed this rope leftover that I had. And then I just placed my cactuses in a random different random way actually. I was not even going for any particular way, but yeah. Just adjust them as the way you want to, and it looks super cute.
I am so much obsessed with my organizer, especially that table paint tube one. I am definitely gonna make more of that for myself because I have a lot of paint tubes still in my boxes, and I want them to organize them like this. They look super cute on my table. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure you let me know in the comments that which particular DIY was your favorite, and if you recreate any of these, do share with me. I would love to feature it on my Instagram. And yeah, I guess it is pretty easy. Anyone can make. We all have these cereal boxes, rolls, and you know, shoe boxes at home that are just lying around. We can definitely use them to organize our stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are liking my DIY videos or videos in general. So make sure you subscribe, please go and press that red button and also the bell button next to it so that you don't miss any of my videos. And follow me on my Instagram. Remember, in one of my haul video, I told you that I got these eyeshadow palettes. So I did like my first try at makeup ever. I have a full reel video on it also, so make sure you check it out on Instagram. I guess this is the last part for my DIY room videos, and I think I am pretty satisfied with my room decor now. I just have to make one thing more, I think. I'm not sure about it, but yes, next video or maybe next to next video will be a room tour definitely for you guys. So stay tuned. I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye.